Blue River in Milltown, Indiana claims the life of two people in the past 2 days. Officers say it's bizarre for this to happen, and now the safety of the water is being questioned. Jessica Oh joins us now with more.
Vicki, 16-year-old Alyssa Knight died Tuesday evening when current swept her over a 15-foot dam. The very next day, 69-year-old man died after being trapped under his canoe. And tonight, Indiana Conservation told us it's extremely unusual to see two deaths on the river, especially within a 24-hour period.
I can't recall in my period of time working in this area of an event like that, you know, ever happening.
The first of those two events involved Alyssa Knight, a North Harrison High School teen who was trying to swim across this river. As we were covering that story, crews were actually called out to another rescue. The canoe 69-year-old Bill Chappell was in capsized after hitting a tree that had fallen across this river. He was wearing a life vest, but it didn't end up making a difference.
He actually went in the water and got pinned underneath a solid object.
This is Chappell being flown to the hospital where he later died. Tonight we got a chance to talk with his family in Boonville, Indiana over the phone. They told us they're extremely angered and feel this really could have been prevented.
Why was it not disclosed to them that a 16-year-old girl had drowned within a couple of miles from where Bill and them was trapped? Had they known, they would not have gone. My children will never know how great and how wonderful their grandfather was now.
Two families dealing with death after their loved ones visited this place. Officers say the calm waters can be deceiving and even dangerous.
What did these two deaths say about Blue River?
Even though a waterway is normally safe, that if people make bad choices and then there's other natural circumstances to go along with it, then a serious incident can occur.
And we do want to point out that if you want to swim or canoe in Blue River, it's at your own risk. But currents can be very dangerously strong there, and officials say there are no signs warning people about that. So they want to remind everyone to be extra cautious. I'm Jessica Oh, WLKY News.
Thank you, Jessica. Funeral arrangements for Bill Chappell are pending. Alyssa Knight will be laid to rest Saturday at the Cedar Hill Cemetery in Corydon.